Holidays are one of the things that we all look forward to, and that can include bank holidays or countrywide holidays. But when they change every year, trying to make sure that you've got the right date in your calendar is an important thing to do. New Outlook does give us an option, not exactly the same as Classic Outlook, though. But let me show you how to do it in today's video. Hi, I'm Michelle, a computer coach here sharing tips and tricks on your everyday software to help to make life that little bit easier. Here I am in New Outlook, in the calendar. So the new method to add the public holidays in is find add calendar at the calendar list. And I'm going to go down to holidays. And you can see that what I've got is all the different countries. You'll also see that there are religious holidays. So we should see. So there's Christian, there's Holy See, Vatican City, Islamic, Shia, Sunni. Apologies if I'm mispronouncing these. But you can scroll down and you should be able to see quite a few. There's Jewish. Won't have absolutely everything, but it should have the key options that you might be looking for. In this case, I'm going to look for United Kingdom. And because I know that quite a lot of you are from the US, let's add the US in as well. I don't know if you can see, but in the background, I've got things happening. And now that I've ticked those, I'm going to click on the X and close them down. And you can see that they have now been added into my calendar. That's under my personal account, which I've greyed out. If you want to contact me, please do use the business account, but not my personal. But the catch is these are actually separate calendars. I need to actually click on them. Where are you? Where have you put them? Let's go and find a week where we had. There you go. So, in your calendar, you'll actually see them displayed at the top. Let's go forward to August, which at the time of recording is the next UK bank holiday. There you go. I've got late summer, I've got them highlighted there. However, it's displaying it as an all-day event. One thing to bear in mind is because this is a separate calendar, it won't send out reminders. If you want to add them as events in your calendar, then you're going to have to do one of two things. Either move them over or copy them over, or if they can be downloaded as events that you can import into your calendar separately. Remember to click the thumbs up button down below to like this video, and I will see you next time.
If you've recently started using the new Outlook desktop application compared to Classic, then you're going to want to sign up and get access to my spreadsheet where I'm recording all of the differences that I'm finding as I go through what's been removed, what doesn't work, and what's been added. This is free. You simply need to sign up. You will be joining my mailing list and you'll get access to the latest version as I update things. The link is displayed below or in the description. Click on the options to expand the description depending on which application you're using.